Hi, I'm Mary Poplin with Boris Effects, and today I'm going to show you how to turn this shot into this shot. We're going to use the Remove module to take the talent out of this shot, and then we're going to use Particle Illusion to put her back in at smoky transparency. And though this shot looks dramatically complex, it's actually pretty easy. So let's get started. I'm going to delete all my previous layers and start from scratch. The first thing we're going to do is we are going to select Mocha Pro from our effects and presets and drag and drop it right on to our original layer. And then we're going to launch Mocha Pro. And then we will launch Mocha Pro by clicking the Mocha button. This will read our footage directly off our timeline. The next thing I'll do is take the freehand tool and draw a shape right around my ghost woman, just like this. And that's just way too many points. So I'm going to take my detail down quite a bit. Now I'm going to select my shape and relax the corners and adjust it anywhere it needs to be adjusted. Now using translation, scale, rotation, and shear, since this is a garbage mat, I'm going to track backwards. Since this is a garbage mat, it doesn't need to be perfect, but I do need to make sure that I don't leave any of her hairs on the background. As a tip, you can always use the Activate Quick Stabilize mode to roto a little bit faster by keeping your shape pinned into the center of the screen. Once your roto is complete, you can track the background walls. Now this is actually slightly tricky because while this looks like a single plane, in order to get a good remove, I have to have a rock solid track. And if you notice, there's actually a corner here, which means these two walls are at an angle to one another, which means they're not the same planar track. So I'll take my large rectangle tool and I will draw two shapes around my walls. And I'll track translation, scale, rotation, shear, and perspective. We're going to name our layers so that we know what we're doing, and we're going to move our ghost layer to the top, our right wall, and our left wall go underneath the ghost layer. That means when we track our right and left walls, that we will have the ghost lady held out of them. Let's show you with mats. When we click on our wall, you can see that we are not tracking where those shapes overlap. That's because Mocha treats everything at the top of the layer pile as closest to the camera and will always hold it out from the layers beneath. We're going to turn our gear off on the ghost, go to our first frame, turn our mats off, and I'm going to actually select both of these with my surface tools on so I can see what my track is doing. Tracking translation, scale, rotation, shear, and perspective, and I hit track forward. It is essential to get a rock solid track to get a good remove. Since I have a previous version of this file, I'm not going to make you sit through me retracking the whole thing. Suffice to say, I have my ghost roto, and I have my right and left walls tracked properly. So now I want to remove this ghost. So I select my ghost layer and I go over to Clean Plate Clip. I want to find an area where I think I can remove the most of the ghost and get the most of the back wall, which is probably going to be somewhere around here. I want to make sure that she's not blocking this lantern because I want that in my clean plate. Now I'm going to ask Mocha to remove her using this background track. So I hit Render. And what you're going to see is that the remove is going to work to try to get rid of her. It's using all of the frames before and all of the frames after, and I didn't use auto step, but I probably should have because it would speed up my render. So let's hit stop. Let's click auto step and ask Mocha to look a little bit smarter. Now what you can see is that Mocha's done its best to remove her, but since her shape is so big, it doesn't have enough data to replace her with. So what we need to do is we need to create a clean plate. So we hit create clean plate, and then we save a clean plate in our project folder. Inside of Photoshop, I'm going to navigate to my project folder and I'm going to find my clean plate. Then as a cheat, I'm going to come in and select an inner edge here using the lasso tool, and I'm going to use Edit, Fill, and Content Aware Fill to fill this, which your mileage will vary depending on the shot. That's actually pretty good. But now I need to clean up little areas. And that's going to be my new clean plate. I'm going to hit File, Save, and then back over in Mocha, I'm going to hit Use Clean Plates Exclusively and hit Render. And you can see that this will take her completely out. If I need to make any more clean plates, I can use my original clean plate to make more. Since this shot has a lot of pans, I need to make a couple of clean plates. Now when I render over time, my remove works properly. We're going to save and close. I'm going to duplicate my layer. I'm going to take my background and I'm going to call it background and keep my top layer as ghost patch. I'm going to go to my mats. I'm going to apply a mat. What that will do is that will apply the mat of my ghost. I'm going to feather the mat. But what I actually want to do is I want to make two patches. I want to make a left wall patch and a right wall patch. So I'll duplicate my layer. And we'll do a left and a right. Let's go to frame one. Let's go to frame one and let's check render and remove. And render and remove. And we'll end up with this nice remove. Now I'm going to duplicate my background. And I'm going to call this ghost. We're going to create AE masks. And that will patch my ghost lady over the top of my shot. In my mask, I'm going to feather like 60 pixels out from her edge to blend her back in over the top. Now I can do a couple of things here in order to make her transparent. But the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go over here to S, glow, and I'm going to drag and drop a sapphire glow right on top of her. And we're probably going to take that glow down just a little bit. So there's my sapphire glow on my ghost to make her pretty ghostly. I can use an action VFX clip like this, and I can time offset it a little bit and use it as a luma mat to make a transparent ghost using that smoke. But what I'd really like to use instead is the continuum particle illusion to create a smoke effect and use that as the mat. So we're going to do no track mat really quick, and we're going to hide this layer. We're going to go to layer, new, solid. And I'm going to make a black solid and call this particles. We're going to go to our effects and presets and find particle illusion. And we're going to drag and drop it right onto our clip. Then we're going to select launch particle illusion. Now inside of particle illusion, you can see I have my emitters and I can search them. I have my properties and then I have my timeline. This is pretty easy to set up. I'm going to search for vapor over here in emitters. And I'm going to grab Complex Vapors 3, and we'll double-click that right on our timeline. And I'm going to make it much larger to fit the area of my shot. Now, the problem with that is my particles stayed the same size. So I need to go ahead and increase the size of my particles, just like this. Now, the next thing I'm going to search for is Magic Smoke. And we have Magic Smoke Wisps. I'm going to use Magic Smoke Wisp 1, and again, I'm going to make a bigger box, and I'm going to increase the size of my particles, and we're going to use Magic Smoke Wisps 2 as well, doing the same thing. And with a little bit of size adjustments and a little bit of adjustments to the speed, I end up with a nice smoke cascading effect. You can see that this now renders back to my timeline inside of After Effects, and it actually renders pretty fast. So we're going to drag Particle Illusion over here to Ghost, and we're going to use this as a luma mat, just in the same way we had used it previously. Now if I want this to match my world, I can copy, well, I can cut and paste this right on my background. I can select transform as world plus emitter, and under the motion tracker and mocha, I can select the mocha motion tracker. Now that's the emitter offset, and I want my emitter to be there. And here's my world transform, and I want that to be over here. So this is going to track my world, and this is going to track my subject. And we're going to go ahead and hit track forwards. Once your track is complete, save and close mocha continuum. And now your BCC particle illusion will be properly tracked. So we can cut and paste this back onto our solid. Now, the reason we had to cut and paste it is because if we wanted to read off the timeline, the data we want to track is actually on the background. Now when we hit play, My smoke will move along properly with my lady. But I see one more problem that I want to fix, and that is I want to adjust her eyes to be a little more opaque. So I'm going to go back to my original Mocha file, and I'm going to use my round solid tool, and I'm going to use my add to round solid tool to make these both on the same layer. I'm going to call these eyes, and I'm going to link them to my ghost track. I'm going to do some corrective roto, and we're going to save. I'm going to go to export my shape data, and I can actually go to my Mocha shape data for After Effects and copy it to the clipboard because this is Mocha Pro. I'm going to make a new layer, drag it and drop it above my transparency, call these eyes, and then I'm going to go to edit, paste Mocha mask, and my eyes will now be on top of my ghost. Now obviously that is way too much, so we need to go to a couple of things. We need to select the eye shapes, and we need to make like a feather of 60, maybe more, feather of 100. All right, so there's her eyes highlighted, but that's still too much. We're going to come over to our transform, and we're going to knock this down to like 50%. And I'm going to go to my ghost. I'm going to select my glow, and I'm going to paste it onto my eyes as well, so that we get the same matching glow. Now her eyes are a little bit more visible and they pop more in my scene. And so with not a lot of work, we have removed this ghost from the background, put her back in at transparency, and used particle illusion to isolate her with smoke. If you have any questions, you can find us at www.boriseffects.com.